Hi there. I just want to demonstrate one of the techniques that I describe in my book, Play Irish Music on the Chromatic Harmonica. And it's a technique called harp-switching. Now, as I describe in the book, it's often best, most effective, most musical to really choose a particular harmonica for each particular tune, the way that tune sits most easily. But often in Irish music you get tunes arranged into sets, and often there's a key change between those sets. So then the question arises, how do you cope with that key change? Now, given that you know, it's best to play a particular tune or easiest or most musical on a particular harmonica, the only answer really is to switch harmonicas at the key change. And these key changes are basically instantaneous in the sense that the rhythm and the groove must just continue. So you have to practice the actual change itself, the harmonica switch, so that the rhythm and everything just keeps going really smoothly. I'm just going to demonstrate with a couple of tunes that I demonstrate on the CD as well, track 73 I think it is. So we're just going between Paddy Clancy's jig, which is in D, played on a D chromatic, and then the Kesh jig, which is played in G on a G chromatic. And I'm just using two totally stock, well, slightly tweaked, but the stock CX-12 chromatics that I offer as optional harmonicas for the book. They're just a normal tuning, but these ones have been half-valved as I offer on the website. The way I hold them is to adopt this kind of position here, which is pretty much the same as you'd do if you were holding a microphone in your hand when you're playing blues harp or whatever, or chromatic. So the bottom chromatic, the one I'm going to change to, sits in these fingers of my left hand here, with the button facing down. And the one I'm playing obviously is in my, you know, in playing position. So what I'm going to do is, as I change, I'm going to be going from this position and then moving that one up there, aiming with it, and this one comes down and I change. I'll show you one more time. So basically it's going like that, and then lifting that one up, that one comes down, and then we go like that and I play. Do that a few more times. Sometimes they clatter a bit, but basically. Okay, let's try it and practice with these two tunes. So first, the way to do it is to play the last phrase of the B part, and then the first phrase of the A part of the second tune. The last phrase of the B part of the first tune going into the first phrase of the A part of the second tune. Paddy Clancy's So basically I have to go from hole number 9 on the D harp to hole number 3 on the G harp, and as I say, do it without any alteration of the rhythm. So I'll just practice that slowly, then we'll slowly get a little bit faster. You can see how it all works. Okay, and again. And again. Okay, and a little bit faster. I'll do the whole of the B part now and the whole of the next A part. One more time. Okay, I hope that gets across the idea. And as I say, it's just a matter of practicing, really. Another way to do it would be maybe to hold the harps in one hand, sort of stacked up like that, and switch between them. But I find that quite awkward, and I don't think the sound is as good when you do that. So I prefer to do this this handy little switch over. And as I say, it becomes really quick once you practice it, as with anything.